So, a very good morning, dear students. Welcome to my channel, Maths with Mahanti Sir. So, children, in the last class, we were discussing one important property of cyclic quadrilateral, where I discussed how to prove that if one pair of opposite sides of a cyclic quadrilateral are parallel, the other pair will be equal and the two diagonals are equal. It was discussed in detail in the last class. Today let us discuss another important property. Suppose in a cyclic quadrilateral you are given that one pair of opposite sides equal. How will you prove that the other pair parallel? Let us see. Suppose you are given ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral and you are given this one equal to this one. I mean AD equal to BC. That I have written here in given. ABCD is a cyclic quadrilateral and AD equal to BC. So how will you prove that your AB parallel to DC? See children, in order to prove AB parallel to DC, you just join diagonal BD, construction C, join BD. Now see children, if we can show by joining the diagonal BD, look at this angle and this angle. If by any means we can show that angle 1 and 2 are equal, if we can show angle 1 and 2 are equal, they form a pair of alternate interior angles with the transversal BD. Look at BD joins AB and DC, so no doubt it is the transversal, and these two angles form a pair of alternate interior angles. If these two angles can be shown equal, so no doubt AB and CD will be parallel, because we know if a pair of alternate interior angle is same, then the two lines, they are parallel. So now the point is how to show angle 1 equal to angle 2. Let us see. Let me discuss the proof part. See. So children, you are given AD equal to BC. It is given. Okay. You see, these are the two opposite sides of the quadrilateral. But these are two chords also. AB, AD and BC are also two chords of the same circle. And children, you know, if two chords are equal, their corresponding arcs are congruent. You see. So AD equal to BC means arc DA. See, this is the arc DA. Arc DA will be congruent to arc CB. Why? Because the two chords are what? If two chords are equal, their corresponding arcs will be congruent. Now the point is, if two corresponding arcs are congruent, what will happen? See, if these two are congruent, then they will, you know, equal chord subtend equal angle at the center. Suppose I will take the center here, O. Now see, so at O, whatever angle this arc or this chord will subtend, the same angle will be subtended by this arc or this chord BC, because the two chords are what? Equal and the two arcs are congruent. So we can say that, you see, that means angle AOD, angle AOD will be equal to angle COB. Why? Because equal chords, you see, equal chords subtend equal angle at center. Equal angles at center. Okay. Now the point is, you see, so AOD will be equal. You join this, no problem. You join this one. You can join C. Join the center C. This is O. So AOD will be equal to angle COB. But look at angle AOD. It will be twice angle 2. Why? Because you see, you know, angle subtended by an arc at the center is double the angle subtended on the remaining part. So this arc subtends angle AOB at the center and angle 2 on the remaining part. So no doubt AOD will be equal to twice into 2. Similarly, this arc subtends this angle COB at the center and angle 1 on the remaining part. So no doubt angle COB will be twice angle 1. See, very simple now. So angle AOD will be 2 into 2, because AOD is the angle subtended by this arc DA at the center. It will be double angle 2, because angle subtended by an arc at the center is double the angle subtended by the same arc on the remaining part. In a similar manner, this angle COB is the angle subtended by this arc at the center and angle 1 on the remaining part. So no doubt angle COB will be double angle 1. This is angle 1. So that I have written here. In place of angle AOT, I have written 2 into angle 2. In place of COB, I have written angle 2 into angle 1. Okay, the reason I said. Okay, now 2 you cancel. Now you cancel 2 and 2 from both sides. So what you will get? 2 equal to 1. See. So angle 2 is now proved equal to angle 1. But what angles are they? But these are means angle 2 and 1. But these are a pair of what angles? Pair of alternate interior angles with transversal BD. Joining which two lines? Joining your AB and CD. Joining AB and CD. You see. So, you see, if angle 2 equal to angle 1, but you see, angle 2 and 1 are what angles? They are a pair of alternate interior angles. With which transversal? BD. Joining which two lines? AB and CD. So, no doubt, as these two angles are equal and they form a pair of alternate interior angles, so no doubt AB will be parallel to CD. Therefore, AB parallel to CD. So, this is what we wanted to prove. This is what we wanted to prove. So, what did we prove in this property of cyclic quadrilateral children? In this property, we proved that in a cyclic quadrilateral, if one pair of opposite sides are equal, then the other pair will be what? It will be parallel. That means the cyclic quadrilateral will become a cyclic trapezium because one pair became parallel. Okay. One pair of opposite sides became parallel. So, that means it will become a trapezium and is a cyclic trapezium. Okay. Children, I hope you understood this very important property of cyclic quadrilateral. Okay. So, there is one more property left. I shall discuss it in the next class. Children, I hope whatever I discussed, all the properties, whatever properties of cyclic quadrilateral I discussed, you must have understood. If at all it is true, children, you please hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Okay. So, I will discuss another important property of cyclic quadrilateral in the next class. Thank you.